Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. What the ChargerLAB brings to everyone today is the Teardown of Apple 20W USB-C power adapter. This charger firstly appeared as a standard accessory for iPad 8th generation, but it still has to wait for the release of the iPhone 12 series, and then it caught the people's attention. Cause Apple canceled the charger inside the box, so the customer has to buy this 20W charger additionally. And of course, the price of Apple accessories has always been very stable. The price has not changed since it was released. It has always been $19. And we bought this Apple's 20W charger from Apple's official website. Let's take a look at the packaging firstly. We can see that what's inside the box at a glance. The charger power is printed in multiple languages on the back. The specification is on the side label. Okay, let's unbox it. Except for the charger inside the box, just a manual. There is a protective film covering the charger to prevent surface from scratches. The appearance of Apple's 20W PD charger is pure white, very simple. And it adopts the fixed pins, not foldable. Let's see the specification here. The manufacturer is Cellcom Technology. It supports the volt input voltage of 100 volts to 240 volts and can be used worldwide. The maximum rated current is 0.5 amp. For output, it has two PDOs of 5V 3A and 9V 2.22A. Model is A2244. There is also a serial number here, printed on the shell and burned into the chip. The USB-C port is in the middle, and the plastic insertion is also white. Let's take a look at the size, which is about 41.4mm, 42.4mm and 27.3mm. The weight is about 58 grams. Let me show you the whole Apple charger family. Apple 18W, 20W, 29W, 30W, 61W, 87W, 96W power adapter. Apple's 20W charger is exactly the same as the 18W in appearance. We have torn down the 96W, and you can check that in the right corner. And except for today's 20W charger, it'll bring the teardown of Apple 30W very soon. If you want to see it, you can subscribe to our channel and turn on the remind button. Let's test the performance of the charger. We can see the serial number via ChargerLAB Power Z MF001, same as what printed here. Continue to use ChargerLAB Power Z KT002 to test the supporting protocol. Only Samsung 5V 2A, DCP, and USB PD 2.0 can be supported. And it has two fixed PDOs of 5V 3A and 9V 2.22A. Use the ChargerLAB Power Z KM001C to test the charging power, 8.88 volts, 2.18 amp. So the power is about 19.4 watts with PD protocol. Okay, after unboxing and testing, let's start to tear it down. We have said in the teardown video of 96W that the Apple's power adapter is very difficult to take apart. So let's directly call our cutting machine to save time. Okay, the internal PCB module has been successfully taken out. We found that the elastic plate of the charger can connect to the gold finger of the PCB. There is a black rubber pad in here, used to isolate the pins from the transformer. The shell of the charger is part of the USB-C receptacle port, which is more stable. Then, let's see the PCB module. You can see many components on the front of the PCB, such as inductors, capacitors, and transformers. And they are supported and isolated by plastic. There are fewer SMD components on the back of the PCB. We can see the clear boundary between the primary and secondary circuit. There are PD fast charge protocol chip and V-bus switch on the secondary side. There are multiple holes on the board used to fix a plastic frame on the front. This product adopts switching power supply to output wide range voltage, and then use the protocol chip of secondary circuit to control the output voltage. That's to say, the alternating current comes in from the AC pins and is filtered by common mode choke. After that, it'll be rectified by rectifier and filtered by high voltage electrolytic capacitor. And then the master control chip controls the transformer to step down. and then rectifying and filtering again. Finally, the output is controlled by protocol chip. Next, remove those components on the front. Firstly, remove this common mode choke used to filter EMI interference. You can see that there is an input fuse here. Specification is 1.25A, 250 volts. The high voltage electrolytic capacitor is next to it, which comes from the Chemicon. Specification is 400 volts, 15 microfarad. Here is another high voltage electrolytic capacitor, which comes from Nippon Chemical. Specification is also 400 volts, 15 microfarad. Continue to remove two high voltage electrolytic capacitors. We can find a color ring inductor under the capacitor. Continue to remove the transformer and the plastic frame. The specification is 560 microfarad, 12 volts. The solid capacitor for output filtering is wrapped in tape for insulation. And then let's see what's on the motherboard. This is the master control chip, which has built-in primary controller, MOSFET, and secondary synchronous rectifier controller. It is customized by Apple from Power Integrations. Model is ZN1461C. A synchronous rectifier MOSFET is next to it, which comes from diodes. And let's turn to the back of the PCB. The protocol chip comes from Infineon. Model is CYPD2134. The VBUS switch tube of output comes from ON Semiconductor, with stand voltage is 30 volts. Well, that will be all components for this charger. We have to say the quality of Apple's power adapter is pretty good. It has master control chip from Power Integrations, and its protocol chip comes from Infineon. Rest of the capacitors are all from Japanese brands. But there are still some disadvantages in terms of protocol. It only supports USB PD 2.0 protocol. Even the Apple 2.4a has been blocked. So what do you think of this $19 charger? Will you buy it for your new iPhone? You can leave your comments below. If you like this video, don't forget to drop a like and subscribe to us. See you next time.